Now, your Big 2 Weather Authority forecast with Chief Meteorologist John Mayer. He warns you first.
Well, we're seeing a lot of rainfall out there, but it's not in West Texas. No, it's off to the east, down along the Gulf Coast. This is where we're seeing all of these storms that have been moving in. A lot of tropical moisture there. This isn't a tropical storm, though. This is just a collection of storms moving in from the Gulf. A little bit of a difference there. We did have a chance to see that escalate to tropical storm status. Didn't happen. Not quite organized enough, but certainly bringing a lot of heavy rainfall off to the east. And, well, then there's good old West Texas, where we're continuing to stay clear and dry. Just a little bit of cloud cover out there. Heading into tomorrow, though, the big change, keep an eye on this, cold front off to the north. Exactly how far down does it drop into the Lone Star State before it kicks off to the east? That's the big question mark. And if it does move into the basin, we'll get a good chance for some showers and storms Wednesday evening into Thursday morning. So let's go ahead and track this forward, getting really close there Wednesday evening, and then, well, just sort of veers off to the east. And for the most part, I think that cold front is really going to miss us. And if it does, that means more of the same. Couple degree drop in temperatures, but that's about it. For the most part, I think we're going to continue to stay clear and dry. But if we do see any storms thanks to that front, it'll all be to the north into Lee County, towards Gaines County, Dawson County, Borden County. Unlikely we'll see much along I-20, and definitely not going to make its way south towards I-10. So this is still going to be a pretty dry forecast moving forward, thanks to that cold front just missing out on the viewing area, but definitely packing a punch elsewhere off to the north. We've got that severe weather risk tonight, gets close to the basin into tomorrow evening, but never quite moves that far down to the south. Again, for the most part, I think we're going to miss out on the effects of that cold front, and that means more of this. Temperatures back into the 90s again this afternoon. Certainly not seeing anything too far out of control. No triple digits out there. Not too bad. 94 in Pecos, 94 Fort Stockton, 96 in Presidio, but expect these numbers to slowly tick up day after day as we head towards the start of summer, which is just around the corner. Thursday, the first day of summer, and that's when we're going to see these numbers no longer in the mid-90s, but instead pushing towards record-setting highs. Today's record is 108. Tomorrow, get a little bit closer. 97-degree high in Midland, Odessa for our Wednesday. And then by the time the weekend comes, well, things sort of spiral out of control. We'll get back to that in just a second. But our winds still staying on the calm side for, well, at least West Texas. Single-digit wind speeds for most, but get a little gusty off to the north thanks to that front. And as long as the front misses us, I think these winds will stay relatively under control on the calmer side. And still 20 miles per hour off into the Guadalupe Mountains, but that's nothing new for us. Always seeing those gusty winds off to the west. Overnight into tomorrow morning, lows only dropping down to the mid-70s. Certainly going to see that warming trend, not just with our highs, but also with our lows, continuing to see warmer and warmer weather each and every day, mornings and afternoons both. And tomorrow afternoon, yes, we do see some triple-digit highs. Artesia 100, 102 into Carlsbad, down to the south, 100 in Barstow, 100 in Grand Falls, and a few more of those creeping into the Trans-Pecos. And of course, that southern border as well. But these low to mid hundreds are nothing compared to what we're going to see by this weekend. That is when we get that chance for record setting highs and then some. These numbers continuing to march through the rest of the work week. And then 101 by Friday and Saturday, 108 degrees. That is our record high for that day. So right now I have us tying the mark, but could easily break it and could certainly see those numbers getting a little bit closer to 110 than 108. Certainly a very high hot start to the weekend, and keep it going into Sunday as well. 104 on Sunday afternoon, 100 on Monday, four consecutive triple-digit days before we sort of calm things down a little bit into the middle of next week, dropping back down to the 90s. But no major rain chances through the extended forecast, and plenty of heat just in time for the start of summer. So here we go again. Every time we see a break, it is always short-lived,
right, right.
And this is certainly no exception.
Saturday, wow.
Yeah.
Stay safe. Wear your sunscreen.
Oh, exactly.
I mean, it's Saturday. You're probably going to
very, very probable that we see a heat advisory for that day. Record-setting highs. And that's Midland, Odessa. Imagine how hot it's going to get down towards Presidio.
Davis Mountain.
Yeah.
Summer actually starts
Thursday. Thursday, the first day, and then we just keep on going.
Longest day of the year.
Yeah.
All right, John. Thank you.